Hi all. So today we are going to understand different types of annotation and in which file should we add which type of annotation. Okay, let's get started. So first annotation that we are going to look for is the REST controller. So as our application can expose multiple APIs based on different models, we can have multiple files which are exposing this APIs. So to tell the framework that in which file what kind of APIs are there, we are going to use something called REST controller. Okay, so this REST controller is place where our framework will search when any endpoint is hit. So apart from this, we have, if we control click on this, we can see multiple functionalities that are provided internally. So I will explain one of them is, for suppose in all these APIs, if we have suppose slash API common in every one of them, let's include here as well. Okay, so instead of including slash API in every one of them, we'll try to include slash API here itself. Okay, so that is one of the functionality. Like this, we can have n number of functionalities with that annotation, but basically REST controller is meant to inform framework that if someone is hitting our application, which are the files in which you should search for the exposed APIs. Okay, so this was REST controller, and then we have certain code specific to database configuration or breaking of the connection or any such kind of configuration. So the files which have such logic, in that we are going to write @ configuration. Okay, so we are going to see some other annotation which are similar to this, and then we'll try to understand what that is. Okay, so basically @ configuration is again, so a class which has any kind of annotations kept above it, those will be executed as soon as our application is started. So it will not wait for us to call or create an object of that class. It will simply get executed, and if there is any beans or any other functionalities written in that class, that will be executed, and this will be executed only once for every start. Then we have something called, right, again we have something called service. Okay, and this service configuration and one more annotation called @ component. So these three, and we have one more called @ repository. Okay, so this is like, we can use in either of them in a class, but just for explanation I wrote that. Okay, so if you want to use multiple annotation, you can enter and you can add one more. Okay, but as of now I'm keeping only one. So component, service, repository, configuration, these four annotations are basically doing the same thing, but why do we have different names for them? That is a stereotype. To tell any new developer, just by seeing the annotation, he can identify, okay, this class is just a simple component, or this class is a service that we are going to use in the REST controller. So that is a naming convention for the annotations that we use in general. And then coming to the very crucial thing, that is AutoWire. Okay, so let's consider a scenario to understand @ AutoWire. So there's a class called calculator which has a function called add. So in general, if we don't have any knowledge about auto wiring, what we will do, we'll add calculator, calculator is equal to new of calculator, that is creation of object, then with that object we'll call the methods of this functionality. So the object concept is like any object of the same class will be different from the other object of the same class, because every object will have its own set of variables, its own set of functionalities. Okay, though it is the object of the same class, it will have the similar functionalities, but it will, the state of the objects will be different because the variables or any other thing which is not common in them will differ based on the usage of that object. But coming to these, like suppose this is a component in which you create any number of objects, I don't think we can find any difference apart from the hash code and all. There is no other variable or no other functionality which could be specific to the object. So then there is a no use, like if in the case where we are creating a new object and calling the functionality of add, Suppose the end user is calling add 10 times, then we are creating 10 new objects, and then we are using the functionality of add, which is same in all. So in these kind of scenarios where we don't have specific state for specific object, in that case we can ask the framework to create an object in the initial itself, and we'll use that object throughout the lifecycle process of the application. That is, here we created calculator class, and with this component, when the application is starting, it will create an object of class calculator with the name calculator. That is, the first letter will be small, remaining all will be same. Okay, so we can change the name of the object which the framework is creating for us using another annotation called @qualifier, right? Okay, now that was one more annotation, @qualifier. So because we created an object of the component, if we want to use the object of calculator anywhere, so there we are going to, like, suppose here I want to add. So here, instead of creating an object of calculator, I am simply saying autowire. So what autowire is saying? That there is an object of calculator already created by the Spring Boot application. Just fetch me that object, and I want to catch it with the name calculator, and the functionalities of the calculator I will access with this name. So here we wanted to use the functionalities of the calculator, but we didn't create the new object. Instead, we created the calculator. So how this will be assigned? Okay, so this will be assigned again, because we have a class called calculator service. On top of that, we are writing another annotation. So because of @service, what we are telling Spring Boot is, as soon as you initialize, execute all the code written in this once. Okay, so here if you try to understand, if we add any kind of annotation above the class, that will be executed once at the start of the application. So while start of the application, what we are saying, we need an object of class calculator. So calculator services depend on a class calculator. So calculator will be executed once. Okay, so this will be executed. Now if you, okay, this is how it works, but then there is a one more loophole in this. So if we are saying that I want an object of calculator, which because it is already present, so it means we are expecting that there is an object which is created, and I want to access that. But that will be created only once the class which we are expecting, that is also annotated with some annotations. Okay, let me repeat this thing once again. So here we are going to create an object of calculator service, which is an expecting an object of class calculator. So to create an object of class calculator, the calculator itself should be annotated with some annotations like service, component, configuration, repository, or some other thing, so that the object of calculator is created. The concept of autowire is, instead of creating a new object, fetch me the object which is already created by our Spring Boot and get me that. Now if I want to use calculator service somewhere else, like sample controller, here I want to use so here I want to use the calculator service. So instead of creating new object, I will say autowire, which means there is an object of class calculator service, get me that. I'll use the same object again. So here one more thing, so that was about annotations, but here one more thing is, instead of using that, if you write calculator service is equal to new calculator service, that means you are creating an object for the calculator service by yourself. When you are creating this by yourself, then this calculator service for this class, when you are creating object yourself, this will return null, because since you are creating object, you should handle all the autowires and everything. So that is why, if there is any scope of creating a new object by the developer itself, then you should not include autowire anywhere in that class. I'll repeat that. If you are creating a new object anywhere for a class in your application, then it is not recommended for that class to include autowire. Okay, So that was about AutoWire service configuration and the basic utilities that we use in general. So the one annotation at the repository that I haven't explained in this, but that is used for any tables that is going to persist in our database. For these, if we are going to create an interface to get the default methods like .save, which will insert the record in the database, or to get also, for that interface you're going to use at the right repository annotation. So if you are aware of these basic annotation, then we are good to go ahead with the development. So if you have any query with respect to these basic annotations, you can write down in the comment section. Thank you.